Looking at tonight, I was wondering, what are your expectations with Donald Trump? Does he tone it down a bit, as a lot of the experts are saying, or do you expect him to go with what brought him to the top spot in terms of his demeanor and his approach to the other candidates?
I think that it's impossible for Donald Trump to ratchet back entirely. I mean, that's not his personality. And of course, it's also the reason that voters like him so much at the moment is because he is out there and saying whatever comes to his mind. So I think that he's likely to continue doing that. Now, he has to be careful of what comes to his mind. And if he says something, you know, totally outrageous, obviously the other candidates are likely to land on him. But I think they're wary of doing that if they don't have to do that.
Understood. Is it too soon to say whether this debate tonight is really critical, as sort of a game changer or make or break for any of the candidates that are going to be on that stage, whether it be Trump or you know, Bush or any of those who are going to be on the outer reaches of the stage?
I think that it could be a game changer either for Trump or for one of the others. I think Bush is probably the safest person going into this debate tonight because his whole approach has been slow but steady, and he's raised a great, great deal of money. And I think that, you know, all he has to do is be the grown-up in the room, and that's an easy job for him. It's the others who need to, in some way, punch through and show the voters and the donors why they should be paid attention to. And of course, Trump is Trump. I mean, he's already got all the attention. So the others have to find a way to engage the viewers, voters, donors in a way that that they stand out. And that's not going to be easy.
Cokie, there's been a lot of talk and discussion in New Hampshire about the way the lineup was chosen from national polling. And, of course, we had a voters' forum here earlier in the week. Do you think that we here in New Hampshire should be concerned about the way this lineup was chosen based on national polling? Should we be concerned for our primary as a result of this sort of setup?
Well, the only reason you might be concerned is that it might affect who ends up going the course, staying the course long enough to be in your primary. I mean, if George Pataki, the former governor of New York, considered a successful governor of an enormous blue state, doesn't make it to round one and one quarter, that could make a difference to the voters of New Hampshire.
I understand. Okay, well, I thank you very much.
Okay, good to be with you.
Thank you.